extremely well tonight. So in tonight's video, dude, we hit 215 subscribers. I'm so shook right now. Like, hella shook. Hold up, let me turn up the gain so y'all can hear my mouth noises. But anyways, I just wanted to make this video. I knew I was always gonna make a video when I hit 200. And I just want to say thank you for everybody. Thank you to everybody who has subscribed, who have always liked my videos and commented, and some of you have like totally left such encouraging and beautiful messages, and it's like pretty much on a daily basis. And I just want to say thank you, 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 so much. Thank you so much for just rocking with me, for supporting me, and sorry, my neck itches, and honestly, for just being my homie. Like, thank you so much for chilling with me. I really appreciate that you all, that you enjoy my content, and that, I'm interesting enough to like follow. Anyways, but yeah, in today's video, I just kind of wanted to do a ramble and kind of let you all know a little bit more about myself and kind of go more into depth of who I am, because besides you knowing that I'm vegan and that I like Legally Blonde, the movie, that's kind of it. Sharing more about myself. So, let me just clear my throat. So, one of the topics that I wanted to go over was hobbies. And what are my hobbies? Honestly, they're pretty standard. I'm very much an introvert. Actually, when I took the 16 personalities test, if you don't know what that is, you can look up 16 personalities on Google. And it will tell you, like, once you take that test, what your personality is. I always score INFJ. Rarely have I scored anything else. That's pretty much INFJ is, like, my standard. If you follow that, I really don't follow it anymore. I feel like it's low-key kind of cheesy now. But at the time, I was, like, super obsessed with that. But, yeah. So... and what, like, to do with the mind. So one of the things I love to do, and it's like low-key super nerdy, is research. I love to research different topics. Like, you can Casey got it open, I almost regretted it because I was like, the smell was like crazy. So, and I've heard that it smells crazy. I've even looked up YouTube videos about it and people like their reaction to it. And some people are like, oh my god, it smells like a garbage can. And I'm like, nah, they're lying. But it honestly low-key does. Okay, so durian is one of the fruits that I did discover. And then like, I wouldn't say fruit necessarily. Dishes, like I learned to make chia seed pudding and low-key it snaps. Wait, not snaps, it slaps. Low-key chia pudding is freaking amazing. I mean, it does have an acquired taste. But I feel like it's super easy to make, and chia seeds have a lot of antioxidants and a lot of fiber, so like I pretty much make it on a weekly basis because it definitely helps with the body. And yeah, that was kind of why I went vegan too, was just to kind of like raise my frequency, raise my vibration through my diet. So yeah. Oh yeah, okay. So one of my other hobbies is totally unrelated to the past two things, and I didn't have a good segue for it. They're just literally, I couldn't think of anything that could relate to it. But one of my other hobbies, since I'm an introvert, is I love to play video games. I love video games. And I think it's just the boy in me. It's the Chad. I swear, because especially now that I have like an actual good gaming PC, I will play Overwatch, Apex Legends. If you don't know video games, you might not know these ones, but I play Overwatch, Apex Legends. I actually recently got into, my middle finger just like blew up in front of me. Snapped in front of me. Or popped. And I recently got into Final Fantasy 14 Online, which is an MMORPG. Which I'm trying to figure out. What is an MMO? Oh god. Well, anyways, it's basically like World of Warcraft, but like anime, and it's like super fun. Also, I'm so sorry, I'm like, my brain is kind of scattered right now because like, look at my eyes, I'm so freaking tired. I had to record this video like at 2 a.m. because literally this whole week is like, every time I try to film, there was some type of like divine intervention. I swear, like either something like went on in my neighborhood, my bird was yelling, like my dog was needing me, there was just something. So I was just like, you know what, let me just stay up really late one night and let me record. And I know 2 a.m. is not late for some people, but 2 a.m. is late for me. I'm usually in bed by like 9. And I don't know, I just like to go to bed early, but I also like to wake up early. I'm more of a morning person, I would say. I literally can wake up like at 5 a.m. and like be set. And sometimes it's like a blessing and a curse. channel, like maybe just do like the first verse or the chorus of certain songs, and just kind of post like maybe a 30 or 40 minute video of it, or maybe like maybe 20 minutes or 30 minutes, I don't know. It depends on how many songs I can really like learn, because I don't have a problem with like the tune or the melodic line. I'm just more concerned about when I do a cover, I'm more concerned about the lyrics. I literally have to drill lyrics into my mind. Actually, before I started my YouTube journey, I was always in musicals. I was always in operas. I used to love to sing opera. I was actually, I used to study vocal performance in college for the longest time. I used to think opera was like my passion. Well, it was at one point, but then I realized that like I wasn't fully expressing myself the way I wanted to. I feel like a lot of music and art songs in that era of music is very like it's multifaceted, and the music is beautiful and the poetry is especially beautiful, but it didn't speak to me as an individual, because a lot of times the music is written in one viewpoint, I guess, and which is fine, but it just isn't my viewpoint. So I decided to kind of leave that because I felt like I couldn't really express myself fully. It's kind of like when you make the jump from opera music, or like music that is centered around one subject, and then music that is today. And I feel like the music that is today, pop music and everything, it's so diverse. You can literally talk about anything and people are like, okay. I mean, like that song by Cardi B and Megan Thee Stallion, WAP, like the fact that we can even make music like that today is amazing to me. I feel like it's so liberating and empowering. So yeah, I just see things differently, I think, than a lot of people. Also, yes, I should talk about my spiritual or like my beliefs. So my beliefs, I used to be super into church. Like I used to go to church every week. I used to be in a choir, and I used to always like help out on the Sunday services and everything. I was like above and beyond, and I used to always read my Bible and stuff. And the thing is, it's like, it's not that I've like abandoned Christianity. It's just that I feel like I've ascended beyond it, because I feel like Christianity is like the first step in most people's spiritual journey, and I think that was my first step as well. And those who are seekers of knowledge and seekers of higher realms of consciousness, I feel like a lot of times they often do venture off to different pathways, usually through occultism, like I did. I used to totally be into, you guys are gonna be like, what the, but I used to totally be into like witchcraft and stuff. But I mean, I'm Mexican, so it's kind of normal, because well, like that's kind of our heritage. It's kind of our heritage. If you go to Mexico, there's always people who do like egg cleansings. It's where you rub the egg over your body and it collects the bad energy that is on your auric field. But yeah, it's been kind of part of my journey. But as a child, I've always had spiritual gifts. I always could see auras and portals, and I could always read people's vibrations easily. Even today, I can still do it. Especially when you go vegan, I believe your pineal gland gets decalcified, and that allows your brain to be open to new realms of consciousness. If you are eumelanated, though, I believe your pineal gland is naturally decalcified, but through certain practices and certain diets, it can revert and regress into calcification. So, for instance, eating McDonald's, because it has this channel and future uploads, what I'm thinking about doing. So one of the things that I'm thinking about sharing with you guys is that I did one of those 23andMe DNA tests, and I want to share the result with you guys and kind of what I discovered about myself. So you all probably know by just by the looks of me that I'm Latino. But like, it goes so much deeper, because when I took my 23andMe, it did open up, it did make me realize just more about myself and more about like my heritage. And I kind of already was reconnecting, because I will just say that my family is my mom's side, the heritage there is that they are Yoeme, Native American, or Yoeme Indian, or Yaqui Indian as well. That's another name that they call them, which is Native American, and I believe they come from Sedona, Arizona, but I think my family is mostly originated from the, from Mexico, obviously. But the indigenous parts of Mexico, where a lot of indigenous people are. And so, but my dad is very huerito, so like, that's kind of, you know, that's different. That's kind of why like my skin is in the middle. Like, I'm not dark and I'm not super light, but I'm just kind of like, I don't know. I sometimes kind of call myself like yellow. Because I kind of have that glow or whatever. But anyways, yeah, I think I'm gonna do a video on that of 23andMe, because the results that I got were like super interesting to me, just to see where certain parts of my lineage originated from, where I came from. So I think I wanna do a video on that. But I also bought a green screen, so expect role plays. I love ASMR. I think they're so fun, and I think they really allow the ASMR artists to show their creativity. I used to always act and be in musicals, like I said before, so I love to act. I love to create a character, or I love to really express myself through a character. I think it's one of my talents, and I think it's something that I am good at. Yeah, so I have that. I'm just setting things up, because I still have to get a couple ring lights and stuff to help improve the quality. Right now, I don't even have a ring light. I had to. I'm using like this lamp with this warm lampshade to kind of give my face a little bit of more shine, because I was just having my overhead ceiling titty light. It was good, but it wasn't lighting my face nicely and evenly, so I'm definitely looking into investing in a really good ring light, or a couple actually, but I don't want to get something cheap, because I feel like a lot of times when you do go get cheaper products, they're not very long. Well, number one, they're not very long lasting, and number two, they don't work that well. Or they don't work as optimally as their counterpart, which is a little bit more expensive, which is fine. Which is fine if like that's all you can afford. But I'd rather invest in something bigger and something more expensive that will give me immediate good results than something that I'd have to work with and kind of hassle with and compromise my content for. So yeah, I don't want to, I'm just rambling at this point, but I had to get a video out because I felt so bad. It's almost gonna be 4 days and I haven't uploaded, and I know I say I upload Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, but I'm also thinking about changing my upload schedule, because I'm realizing that Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays work better for me to upload, because by then, a lot of times I have a lot of videos that I can choose between. express my eternal gratitude to you. And just really express to you how blessed I am to have every single one of you by my side.